Submissible to God is called as a Muslim. So this is an Arabic word. I don't know how much does Kabir Khan know about Arabic. So person who does not know Arabic, you ask him the meaning of Arabic word, it is like the person said, you're asking a driver about the treatment of medical disease. I don't know how much Arabic does Kabir Khan know. And what right does he have to comment on Arabic word which he doesn't know? So this is how the media, you know, person doesn't know Arabic and you're asking the meaning of an Arabic word. So what we realize that if you want to know, you go to the authentic sources. And the best definition to know about Muslim is go to the Quran. Quran says that many places about Muslim, God is Muslim, means one a person who bows to the will of Allah. In Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 64 and many other places. Hope that answers.
Yes. Any further questions?
Yes. Assalamu alaikum, this is Aman Bukhari. Barkha Dutt doubted your reply which you had tried to give about the Taliban's and how the American media, they manipulate the public. And according to her, CNN and BBC are the gospels for her. Now, the very same CNN and BBC had said that Iraq has weapons of mass destruction. And this was being relayed on these channels day after day, week after week, and months after months. And in spite of America invading Iraq, it was not able to find any weapons of mass destruction. My question to Barkha Dutt is, come on, Barkha Dutt, where is your answer to this? Where are the weapons of mass destruction? Your comments, please, sir.
These examples can be given in school. And I do agree with you. Not that I am a fan of Saddam Hussein. Neither do I say that Saddam Hussein is a practicing Muslim. But you know, America attacks Iraq and puts a sanction embargo that no medicine, no food should go there, because of which more than 500,000 children were killed because of the sanction, putting sanctions. Who's to blame? And when they attack Iraq, they don't find any weapons of mass destruction. Who's to blame? I would blame George Bush. It is clear. Why can't she read between the lines? And she's a woman of the media. Or maybe, you know, I don't know why she... It's very evident that even when Saddam Hussein was arrested, he had a trial, inverted commas, whether just, I don't know, irrespective what he has done. In Islam, we have to give a fair chance to the person who is the culprit or the person who you think is responsible. I doubt whether he was given a free chance. Fine, I do agree he has done many evils, maybe, but surely there was no proof of weapons of mass destruction. No proof. And has anyone condemned George Bush? Fine. I know later on many people did say that he's terrorist number one. And when the survey came in America and throughout the world, who is terrorist number one? Is it Bin Laden? Is it Saddam Hussein? Or is it George Bush? And do you know, in all the polls, whether conducted in America or UK or throughout the world, George Bush, he sweeped the polls. The lowest he got was 73%. In some votes, he got more than 80%. Now, when people compared, Americans compared, who is a terrorist? Bin Laden, Saddam Hussein, or George Bush? Even in the BBC poll, George Bush sweeped the polls. Now, doesn't Barkha Dutt know about that? So very, very comfortably, they take what they want from the BBC. And they don't take what they don't want. And this is not again publicized. It comes once and finished. So if Barkha Dutt is a woman of the media, the same BBC says that this is the public opinion. Has she said, come on, BBC?
Shahrukh Khan sounded a little apologetic when he said something somewhere is wrong, but we have to adjust and bear with them. So how far we should adjust and why should we be apologetic?
After watching the program, it appeared that Barkha Dutt and Kabir Khan were trying to promote a new religion known as the moderate Islam, where everything that Islam permits is prohibited and everything that Islam prohibits is permitted in this religion. So your opinion about that?
I would like Dr. Naik to tell all the Muslims that which is the most important aspect as far as Islam is concerned.
You were telling about that 9/11 was an inside job at that time. Barkha interrupted you. How can you prove that 9/11 was an inside job?
Soha made a comment on the show saying that majority of the Muslims are represented by the so-called moderate Muslims who are not practicing. And Brother Najib also added that they comprise of almost 99% of them. So how important is the majority?
I disagree with the comments made by Soha Ali Khan and by Kabir Khan saying 99% not practicing. Yes, he may know, he may be. If he says he is one of them, I've got no problem. But to say 99% are not practicing, I totally disagree.
This is regarding Kabir Khan. He said that I am a Muslim, but I reject all the rituals of Islam. But Islam is in my culture. So what's your comment on that?
Same thing. He says, I am a Muslim, but I reject the rituals of Islam. So how can he be a Muslim?
As I say that I am the bearded man, my father was not having a beard.
MashaAllah. So you are keeping out of free will.
Alhamdulillah. Yeah, that is what I am saying. My mother, she was not wearing hijab. And I got a 5 sister, alhamdulillah, all they are wearing hijab.
MashaAllah. You should give it to Kabir Khan.
Yes, that is what I am saying to Kabir Khan only. My wife is wearing hijab. Her mother was not wearing hijab. So I can dua to Kabir Khan, inshallah, biznillah. Maybe his son will keep the beard and his daughter will wear the hijab.
Inshallah. If they watch Peace TV, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And I pray to Allah that may Kabir Khan also keep a beard.
Inshallah.